make it clean. So the treatment of polluted water in a lab, you can do this activity in your classes or in your lab, and it explains the filtration process in a brief. Whereas the filtration process in big machines is separate. That is how we will, the filtration process is usually is carried out in big machines, but this process explains the filtration process in a brief. This activity can be carried out in your classrooms or in your science laboratory. So in this step one, you have to take a glass jar with water. You have to take a big jar like this with water, and you have to fill it with water, normal pure drinking water. Then you have to add all the waste like grass, orange peels, detergents and ink, any colored ink. So that makes that water polluted. Then you have to cap the jar. Then you have to shake it well. Then you have to keep it in the sun for 2 days. After removing it from the sun for 2 days, you have to shake it again and take a small amount of that water in a test tube and label it with a sticker. And on the label you can write it before treatment sample 1. Then in the second step, this water from this glass jar is taken again and it is passed, aeration is passed through it. That means oxygen is passed through it day and night for 2 days. Through aerator from the aquarium. You know, in the aquarium you see small pipe which gives oxygen through a small motor. Then you switch on the switch. When you put on the switch, the bubbles come. That is aeration process. So with the help of an aerator from the aquarium or a mechanical stirrer, that means you can stir it with a spoon to pass the oxygen, to let the oxygen go inside. So the water from the glass jar, after mixing with this and putting it in the sun in 2 days, to that water you have to pass the aeration day and night with an aerator from the aquarium or with a mechanical stirrer. Then for 1 day you have to do that. Then next day you can take the sample in a small test tube. You have to take the liquid and pour it in a test tube and then label it again. And you can write it, for that label you can write after aeration sample 2. So in the first step, we have polluted the water by mixing few things. We have put it in the sun. Then we have taken a small sample and we have labeled it. The water which was left in the glass jar was aerated with the help of a mechanical stirrer or an aquarium aerator, and then it was taken again in a small test tube, a sample amount, and it was labeled as after aeration sample 2. Then this aeration process gives oxygen to the water. Then step 3, you have to take a beaker. This step is separate. Here you are taking a glass beaker. You are placing a funnel over it. This is known as funnel. And you are adding a filter paper over it. Take a beaker, mount the funnel over it. Then place a filter paper wetted with tap water. Take a filter paper. Filter paper is usually whitish in color. You have to wet it with the tap water and put it in this funnel. In that funnel, you have to add layers of sand. Then put a filter paper wetted with tap water in the funnel. Place layers of sand in the funnel. Pour aerated liquid. So this liquid you have to pour here. So put aerated liquid into the beaker through the funnel. This funnel will get supported in this beaker. So the aerated sample will be poured in this beaker. This funnel consists of a wetted filter paper with layers of medium and fine sand over it. Then you have to filter that water, aerated water, through that filter paper. You will get a clear water. Until you get a clear water, you have to repeat that process. So this will give you a clean, clear water. This step, then take this water in a small test tube and then label it again as filtered sample 3. Then moving on to step 4, this filtered sample water, take a small amount of that filtered sample water in the fourth test tube and add a chlorine tablet. Then after that, mix it and label it with a test tube called chlorinated sample. As you add the chlorinated water, the chlorine disinfects the water. So what do you observe from these 4 test tubes and these 4 samples? The aeration process removes the odor, that is smell, the bad smell from the test tube. Bad smell from the polluted, unclean water will be removed through the aeration process. So your observation is that aeration removes the odor and the bad smell. And then in the fourth step, from the filtered water, disinfectants will be removed through chlorine. So chlorine disinfects the water. So this is what you observe. But one thing what you have to note in this activity is never taste the water, because it is full of chemicals not suitable for drinking. So in this 4 samples of test tube, you have done how the water is treated. So first step, you have added the water, pure water, you have added all the pollutants like grass, orange peel, detergents and ink. You have kept it in the sun, then you have mixed it and taken a sample of the unclean water. Then after that, you have passed aeration into the water. That means oxygen and other gases you have passed. That removes the bad odor of that unclean water. That process is known as aeration. Then you have filtered the water further with the help of layers of sand that gives you a clean water. That is filtration process. Then this filtered water is further purified with the help of chlorine. The chlorine disinfects the water. Finally, you get a clean water. This is a small brief activity to explain you the cleaning of the polluted water. Now on a large scale, we will see how wastewater is treated in the plants outside. On wastewater treatment plant, on a large scale in industries, in big areas, how wastewater is treated, we will learn. So wastewater treatment plant involves the physical, chemical and biological processes which removes the physical, chemical and biological matter that contaminates the wastewater. Physical means all the solid substances, then biological means composed of all microbes, chemical means all the metals, chemicals, etc. So this wastewater treatment process, in this the first process is, first step is passing through the bar screen. There will be a metal like bar screen where water will be flowed through a great pressure. That bar screen removes the racks. Racks means waste old cloths, sticks, plastic cans, napkins and all those large things will be removed when the water is passed through a bar screen. Bar means you understand, straight lines and columns. So when through the passage of the bar screen, big solid substances will be removed. Then after that, the water will be passed through a grit and a small grit sand removal tank. Grit and sand removal tank. In this tank, the water speed will be reduced and the water will be allowed to stand. The water will be allowed to be stagnant. So water speed is decreased to allow sand and the pebbles to settle down. So here in bar screen, the water will be flown with a great speed. Whereas in a grit and sand removal tank, the water speed will be decreased and the water will be allowed to stand like that for some time so that some particles, big sand, pebbles, stones will be allowed to settle down. From after the removal of grit and sand, the water will be moved to a large tank. In the large tank, the slope is made in the middle. So if the tank is like this, there is slope in the middle. So that in that slope in the middle, the solid feces settle at the bottom. So the solid waste particles will settle at the bottom of the tank, which is sloped in the middle. So solid feces settle at the bottom, and that solid feces which are settled at the bottom are removed through a scraper. Scraper is nothing but a knife-like thing. So solid feces which are settled at the bottom are removed through a scraper. So those scraped means nothing but, if you scrape, you see people scraping potatoes in your houses, right? Your mothers, your other cooks are scraping vegetables sometimes to remove their peels. They scrape bitter gourds and all things. So like that only solid feces are removed through scrapers. They are scraped with the help of a scraper. So this process of removing the solid feces through a scraper is known as nothing but sludge, and are scraped into scrapers. And this solid part is known as sludge. The solid part which was scraped from the bottom through a scraper, that solid part what you get after scraping is known as sludge. So one more thing, there is also known as skimmer. Skimmer removes oil and grease from the tank, from that water. So from then this water is known as the clarified water. So from this water, usually which is moved into a large tank, there is a slope in the middle. In that, from that middle, whatever human feces or other waste settled down are removed through a scraper. So that waste which is removed through a scraper is known as the sludge. Then other than sludge, there is one more thing called skimmer, which removes the oil and the grease. That makes the water pure, which is known as the clarified water. Then this sludge is transferred, the sludge, the waste material which was scraped, will be transferred to a large tank where it will be decomposed with the help of a bacteria. Then this decomposition of a bacteria produces biogas. This biogas can be used as the fuel for electricity purpose. Electricity can be produced with the help of the biogas. Then this sludge is mostly composed of water. Then the water is moved to a large tank which is sloped in the middle. In the middle, the solid feces settle down. These feces are removed through a scraper. Then this thing which was scraped from the bottom of the tank is known as the sludge. Then there is one more thing called skimmer, which removes the oil and the grease. This gives us a pure clarified water. So sludge is then passed to a large tank, in which large tank there will be decomposition by the bacteria. This decomposition of the bacteria produces biogas, which can be used for fuel for electricity. Then in this clarified water, what we have got from this step 3, from this clarified water we will be passing some air. So what does this air do? The air helps the bacteria from the sludge to grow and multiply. And then the bacteria eats the human and the food waste present in the water. and the soap and the unwanted material, everything it eats from the clarified matter. When we pass air, the bacteria multiply, grow and eats all the unwanted matter from that waste. So then after many hours of this process, suspended particles settle at the bottom. So the main particles, heavy particles settle at the bottom and the top only water floats. Then the top water will be removed and the remaining suspended particles will only remain. That way is known as activated sludge. So after many hours, suspended particles settle at the bottom. So those suspended particles are known as activated sludge and the water which floats at the top will be removed. Then this activated sludge is also made up of 97% of water. Then how does this water dry up from this sludge? The water is removed by sand drying beds or by machinery beds also. Sand drying beds or machinery beds remove the water from the activated sludge. Then the sludge can be used as a manure for the soil because it is bacteria rich, nutrient rich. So this is the way by which water is purified in a broad basis on a large scale in a wastewater treatment plant. It includes bar screens for the removal of big solid substances. It includes grit and sand removal tank where the water will be allowed to stand for some time, where the sand, stones and the pebbles will be removed. Then you go for a large tank which will be sloped at the middle. From that middle part, all the human feces and all the matter will be settled at the bottom and the matter will be scraped away. So that scraped away matter will be known as sludge. Then skimmer is also a thing which removes the oil and grease from the water. So after removing of this oil, grease and the sludge, the water will be known as a clarified water. Then sludge is then passed to a large tank and it is decomposed with the help of a bacteria which produces biogas. Then through the clarified water, air will be passed. That air helps the bacteria to grow further and consumes all the waste part of the bacteria. That further purifies the bacteria, that further purifies the water and makes it a little more pure. Then after some hours from the clarified water, all the suspended particles will settle down. Then the top water will be removed. And then the particles which have settled down are known as the activated sludge. So here sludge was passed to a large tank where bacteria were grown, and into that clarified water, into the sludge, air was passed that helped the bacteria to grow further. Air helps the bacteria to multiply and respirate and grow further in number. So after many hours, the suspended particles settled at the bottom. That is known as the activated sludge. Then from the activated sludge, the upper water was removed. But still then, there is water in this activated sludge. 97% water is present in the activated sludge. Then water is removed from this activated sludge through sand drying beds. Then now you understand, because the water is removed from the activated sludge, only the dry part remains. That dry part can be used as a manure to the soil. It gives rich bacteria to the soil. Now we have got a pure water. After removal of the sludge from the clarified water, we have a little bit pure water. But then the treated water is having low organic and suspended matter. It is not ready for use. The treated water has low organic content and suspended matter. So this treated water will be further discharged or sent into the sea or river after disinfection with chlorine. Chlorine disinfects the water, right? Then the nature further purifies the water by itself. So in this wastewater plant, some amount of the water will be purified. After that, the treated water will be discharged into the seas and rivers, by which the nature automatically purifies the remaining amount of water. That is about the wastewater treatment plant.